YouTube. Just got a new cockpit in today. Actually, it's my first cockpit. I've been racing on a wheel stand, and I'm gonna go through an unboxing and just a review of build quality on that bad boy right there, the Playseat Trophy Black. Gonna do an unboxing and get it set up and see what I think of my first sim racing cockpit. And just like that, got it all unboxed. It was well packaged. We got all of our bolts, the seat back, looks like the front legs, the back legs where the seat goes, wheel and pedal tray, and some other supports. So let's go ahead and get this together. Well, there it is. All put together. Got the wheels and the pedals installed. Something I didn't like about it. I could only get three bolts into the pedals, but at least they're in the back half of the pedals. I couldn't get bolts into the front, but with the leverage, you should be okay. And this is definitely set up for a direct drive, something better than Logitech stuff. So I will be upgrading in the future, but I am not ready yet. Another complaint I have is there's not much as far as cable management. So I have these cables coming out here, and I zip tied them here, here, and here, separated my USB, and followed it down, zip tied here and here to take up the slack of everything else. But then I have the power brick for the whole unit zip tied here. I like my pedals pretty flat. There's a lot of adjustment in there. If you wanted, for a shorter person, you could probably adjust these closer. I'm 6'3", 240 pounds. So let me flip this around here. So I've got the pedals set up. I've got the pedals set up pretty nice. It supports me. It supports me pretty well. So I've also got it set at the max level that you can set it at. I probably need to adjust this one. But when you're setting this up, it doesn't say this in the instructions, but loosen these, because this section that you're putting these bolts into here, this section rotates, and it's easier to get these bolts in if this is loose. Just one little tip. Same for this side. Loosen these before you try and screw this in, because this section will rotate a little bit and let you get these bolts lined up. So anyway, I've got my new playseat. Here's where I sit in it. I might need to adjust something under my butt here. I think this needs to be a little tighter. But so far, it's comfortable. Not sure I like where the angle on the seat is yet, but I can adjust that, because you can adjust that right. Can adjust that right under here. There's a bar that goes right here. There's a bar that goes right here that you can adjust the angle of that rear seat. And that's in the instructions, which, by the way, the instructions are amazing. It's a laminated piece, and it's very detailed on what goes where and how it goes in. So anyway, and also, what is this strap for? This strap is in here, but there's nothing that says what it's for. Is it a seatbelt? Is it something for bigger people like me to strap somewhere? Is it another support? I don't know. I can't find this strap
anywhere in those instructions. So anyway, I'm gonna get this set up, see if I set my monitor up.
Playseat Trophy. So far, so good. We'll see what I have. We'll see how I do on my new first race. So when I was going through my video, I realized I didn't tell any or give any pros about this. Pros: solid build. It is. There's no flex in this thing whatsoever. I've done a couple races now, and even when I'm max braking force, I can't feel any movement. Everything just feels so solid, and it's so nice to have everything in one spot and to keep it there in one spot. The next thing is it's very light. It's very lightweight. So when this is also my work desk, so I'm going to be moving this out, and I can move it out wherever I need to, whenever I need to, and just stick it somewhere else. It's going to be perfect for what I wanted to do. The seat, it's not heavy. It's supportive. It's still kind of breaking in. I'm still rubbing me in a couple different places, but this is a new setup. So anyway, I got this one off of Amazon with a special deal that was shipped from the UK. So free shipping from the UK, but I don't know that still is a thing. I ended up paying $630 for this with tax. So it's worth it. But like I said earlier, this is begging for a direct drive setup, and I will give it to it at some point.